Acha Complex Public. So first of all, I would like to thank all my viewers for giving me 300 plus subscribers and more than 1000 views. So let's get to the topic. While buying a smartphone, we all be in a confusion whether to go for a Snapdragon processor or a MediaTek one. So today, I will sort out all the differences between them, which one is better and which one is not. So before that, let's get into some of shops here and we'll get to know what's the public demand and which one is ruling the market. So let's go.
So friends, here we have Hitesh from Attitude.
So sir, first of all, let us know which branded phones are sold here. I So lagbhag in 10,000 se 15,000 mein kaun sa processor ka device milta hai? MediaTek hi milta hai. तो आपका कहना है कि लोगों में ज़्यादातर डिमांड MediaTek है, Snapdragon का भी है, लेकिन डिफरेंस क्या होता है दोनों में? हैंग का प्रॉब्लम नहीं होता Snapdragon का.
So guys, we visited some of the other shops too and got the same answer again. As it seems, MediaTek covers the 60% of the market and rest of the people go for Snapdragon processors. So let's figure out the differences between them. First of all, Qualcomm, which produces the Snapdragon processors, has a strong market in the Western countries, whereas MediaTek is strong in the Asian countries like India and China, etc. And Qualcomm is the oldest smartphone chip maker here. One interesting thing is, both of these companies use the ARM architecture. ARM stands for Acorn RISC Machines. This is a British company which designs the architectures for the microprocessors, and they actually license them and sell the blueprints to the companies like Qualcomm and MediaTek, etc. So here what the difference is, MediaTek just takes the blueprints and starts manufacturing the processor, whereas Snapdragon or the Qualcomm takes the blueprint, works on that and optimizes for the best performance and best use of resources. So the next thing is GPU or graphical processor unit. Here MediaTek uses the GPU provided by the ARM's architecture, whereas Snapdragon or the Qualcomm uses their own architecture called as Adreno. And when you push the MediaTek processor, it starts heating up, whereas it's not the case with the Snapdragon processors. And most of the recent Android games are more optimized for the Qualcomm's Adreno GPUs. So the final conclusion here is, as Qualcomm knows they produce the better chipset compared to other competitors, they charge a lot compared to the others. So the device price also rises. So it all comes to you, whether you want a better feature, better performance and better battery backup, and you are able to invest some extra additional money, then you can go for a Snapdragon processor. And if your budget is tight and if you are finding a featured phone for lesser price, then you can go for a MediaTek powered phone. So I thought this video makes sense and was helpful for you. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, share and subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more videos like this. Thank you very much.